your first association with Amir Khan?
I remember that very clearly. Qayamat Se Qayamat Tak was released on a Friday, and we still weren't very sure whether it was a success or not. It did particularly well, and I remember the hoardings at that time. Who is Amir Khan? Asked the girl next door. And two of the magazines, film magazines, asked me to get in touch with him and to photograph him. So I remember talking to him. I called him up and I said, is that Amir? My name is Gautam Rajakshak. I would like to shoot you. So his voice said, you'd like to shoot me? So I said, why? He said, when? And I said, whichever day suits you. I was just thinking of Tuesday afternoon at about, say, 2 o'clock. Would you like that? So he said, all right. And he was on the dot of two, and we were very satisfied with what I've done today. I would like to do more pictures. So he said, surely. And then I called him for a series of two or three early morning shoots. I said, all right, admirable job you're doing. I said, why? She said, you know, he never gets up till 9 o'clock. And I so cruelly for days on end would just say, Amit, tomorrow 6 o'clock, I've got the time, you better come. These are the clothes that you've got to get. So I really did not realize until very much later, until about 5 or 6 sessions, outdoor sessions were over, that I was actually being such a horror and making him do things which are quite against his own nature. But not a word of complaint, not a word of remorse. On the contrary, lots of words of appreciation and acknowledgement. In fact, I would say that Amit is one of the few people at that time that I really thought was more mature than a person of his age. He was not taken in by the glamour or by this startling success of a teenage hero. Qayamat Se Qayamat Tak, really, really, the film is a cult film. And he, being in it, really rose to tremendous heights of success and achievement. But I never thought that any of that touched Amir. And there's another little story about Amir which I do know, is that Javed Akhtar, I was just, in fact, talking to him about Amir. He said, you know, I'll tell you a very interesting incident about him. At that time, Javed Akhtar was at the Farias Hotel in Khandala writing a script for Rahul Ravel, a film called Arjun. And at the same time, in the same location, Nasir Hussain, was shooting a film of his called Zabardast and another film called Manzil Manzil, which had Sunny Deol in it. And they were shooting at the Farias Hotel. So in the evening, Nasir Saab came over to Javed Akhtar's room. And of course, Javed Akhtar had written for Nasir Saab's Yaadon Ki Barat. So they got into conversation about scripts. And they said, Nasir Saab said, you know, what a pity, love stories are now on the background. More love stories simply because you're so wonderful. So this one little episode, which I heard from Javed, I had the good fortune of actually cross-checking it with Nasir Saab and also with Amir. And they all said, yes, in fact, it is true. At the same time, Amir at that time was helping out people. He, I think, wanted to become a director. He was an assistant director to Nasir Saab. And I think he really has the makings of a great director. And I was just waiting for the time when he would take out an assignment which he would direct. And now Tare Zameen Par is just the beginning. And I think, as I just met him the other day, I said, now the sky is the limit for you because you've got it all. You understand what it is to act. You understand the difficulties of an actor, of getting into a character, of the difficulties of actually shooting people. And now you're on the other cinema. Cinema is Amir. And I don't think that he's got any other interest except cinema. And I think since he's really devoted to that one art form, he's going to do brilliantly, brilliantly well. I will have to say this about Amir. Amir is one of the best soldiers you can get. When he gives you a certain time, he will be there. In the very beginning, when I used to do photo shoots with him, I wanted to bring out different facets of his personality. It just shouldn't be the boy next door. It should be a little different. He should be a bit of a dreamer. He should look a little tough. So I took him outdoor. I've shot him against rocks. I've shot him against telephone cables. I've shot him against beautiful green verdant backgrounds with at the race course. The photographer, you just have to be there and start looking natural in a very, very unnatural kind of situation. So I think Amir is extremely unhappy being photographed. But as I said, the professional disciplinarian in him always says, tell me what to do. I remember once he said, tell me what am I supposed to think? And this was many, many years later. And when I thought that, come on now, Amir is well-versed and he's experienced, so he should be able to do it. So what am I supposed to think? I said, Amir, what do you mean? What is my motivation? I said, in a photo shoot, there is no motivation except that you want to motivate your fans to liking you. Just be pleasant and just be communicative with me. And with that, you will actually be communicating with your fans. But tell me, what should I do? What should my thought process be? And he was just lying around. And I just took one of his shoes and put it in front of him. And I started shooting. And he knew that I was shooting. So he started thinking, he started looking around. A little later, when I stopped, he said, why did you put that shoe there? I said, did it make you think? He said, I was wondering why you put that shoe right in front of my legs. I said, that is why, to give you a motivation. So it's really, really great fun working with Amit, because if you tell him the reason, he's really very sweet. But on the other end, I have seen the other Amir, which I admire more, is that the moment you give him a character, the moment you ask him to replay something which he's doing in a film, and I've shot the publicity stills of many of his films, right from Dil Hai Toh Manta Nahi, then I've shot him for Ishq, I've shot him for Rangila, I've shot him for Raja Hindustani. And there, I don't have to tell him anything, because we go from one section of whatever we are supposed to do for a photo shoot into another for the publicity. And it is he who's then telling me that this is the part of the film that I'm going to enact now. So therefore, I have the stubble. Would you like me to grow the stubble, or would you like me to add the stubble, photographically speaking? And then he would, I said, Amir, I think you're going a little over the top. He said, no, but my character is a little over the top. My character in Rangila is a little bit of a tapori. You would be surprised to see me. I'm sure you won't like me in it. But of course, I liked him as a performer. And yes, he was right. He had to overdo it. He had to overdo it even in pictures so that it would gel with the character that he was doing in the film. Working with him in Ishq, or working with him on Raja Hindustani, where he played the Kashmiri guide, or working with him on the several films that he's done, or Akele Hum Akele Tum, he was again not Amir Khan. He was the character that he was playing. So he's again an intelligent person who gets into the character. It just so happens that it is Amir Khan playing that character. So I really must say that he's an absolute delight to shoot, an absolute delight to work with, when he is in character. Of all that was required, and there was a very demanding director in Dharmesh between the two of them. And since he's the director and Amir is the creator of the role, they have that language going on. All that you've got to do is to make sure that you catch the moment. Only during Raja Hindustani, I think we'd been completely exhausted. We finished everything. And then I said, Amir, just let's do one or two changes which are a little different from what you want. Maybe you could use them in the... So immediately said, all right. And even Dharmesh, okay, what do you want us to do? I said, try this. It gives another nice look of a guide, of a rugged guide, the character that you play. And immediately the props were got and the clothes were, and what do you want me to do? I said, why don't you try this? Because these pictures will also be used for other bits in publicity where there is no reference to the context of you being a guide. But at the same time, you can establish through this visual that you are a Kashmiri guy. And I must say, you give him suggestions, he takes them and he executes them exactly the way you want to. And never ever have I ever had Amir Khan saying, I have to go. Can we stop? Can we do this quickly? Even for Akele Hum Akele Tum, I tell you, that was the only time I think I've been beaten to my own game. I called him at 8:30. He was here at 7:45 in the morning. And there was a little child in the film, and he'd got him too. And the lady of the film, Manisha Koirala, was working all through the night for another film, so she came in late. But I finished with Aamir all the combinations and permutations with him solo and with the little boy. And I shot him alone, even in pictures where they were to be together. And only a few combination pictures we shot of Manisha and him. And then he had to go because he had to go for a 2 o'clock shift. But there was not a moment delay in whatever he had to do. And never would he have thought of leaving until he finished what was expected of him. This I have consistently seen. In fact, for Ishq, there was Ajay Devgan in the film, there was Kajol in the film, there was Juhi in the film, and there was him. And we were shooting for 2 days consecutively, for 1.5 shifts, 2 days. He was absolutely wonderful, getting into the act whenever he was asked to. There were times when he and Juhi had to do things. There were times when Kajol and Ajay had to pose. And there were times when all four of them went to Sabato. One of the great things about shooting with a person like Aamir is that they know that to me as well as to him, work comes first. And therefore, we enlist what we've got to do and we go according to that. And unless that is over, there's no time for fun and games and sitting and chatting. Aamir Khan, the actor, I think I'll put it very clearly in the words of another colleague of his. Kajol had something very interesting to say about Aamir. She said, you know, Aamir nowadays, of course, chooses his films with tremendous care. And every film of his is a class. He has not only worked on the script, he's not only standard, but the general common standard is an excellent one. To say, I thought Tare Zameen Par, he was very sensitive. I liked him in Lagaan. I liked him in a lot of films. I think, again, Aamir makes you relate to him. And again, he doesn't hog the limelight. In a film like Rang De Basanti, he was just one of the four boys. He just happened to have a character that was large, but he never took the focus or the attention from the other three. And I think that is a generosity and confidence of an actor.